Bismillah, here we are with another study tip, tutorial, dictionary trick, or tip, however you want to put it. Okay, I've got my Hans Weir, and we've already done a quick tutorial about the Hans Weir, some of its merits, as well as a tutorial on how to use the Hans Weir. So what I want to do is talk about, and this is a general rule or a trick for dictionaries in your study for the Arabic language. So I'm going to open up my dictionary here, and I'm going to scroll down to one of our entries here, okay? This entry is eta. Eta. Here's the I there. The I, which would mean that the past tense, al-madi, is eta, and the mudari is going to be yeti. So you get the yeti e there, the kesra. Okay, and it also gives us our masdar, which is ityan. Okay, so this is just a little study tip for you. When you come across a word in your reading, in a passage, wherever, you hear it in a lecture or in a conversation, eta, you don't know what the word is. You're going to use your dictionary, of course, unless you can ask on the fly someone, what does that mean? If you don't have anyone to ask, istafsara, to ask an explanation, then you have to go to your dictionary. So what you're going to do is, and this is what I found to be very helpful, you're going to underline the word, all right? Each word that you come across in your dictionary and you look up the entry, you're going to underline it. Okay, that's going to let you know that you've been there. Okay, I visited this word one time. Then you're going to move on. Now, if you come back to the same word, eta, okay, you read it again, you heard it again, you forgot what it means, you're going to put a little dot next to it or a little line right there. As you can see, I have one right there already. That means I came one time and then I came back a second time. Now the second mark is going to be an indication that this could be a frequent word that you're going to see over and over again. So this means that it's important that you learn this word. So what you could do at this stage is go ahead and make yourself a flashcard. All right, we've already reviewed flashcards, how to use them, and how to use them on your smart device, so you can make a flashcard. Now what happens if you come again a third time? So let's say here I am, I'm visiting. I'm going to put a dot next to that. Okay, so I've got a line. And two marks on the side means I've seen this word three times and I haven't learned it yet. The third time, this is the rule. Three times, you have to memorize the word. Because it's now become a sight word of sorts. You're going to see it repeatedly, often, frequent word, eta. Okay, very common word. The meaning of it, of course, is to bring forward, produce, advance, accomplish to the end. And it gives us a lot of different entries here in this Hans Weir dictionary. So the third time, I'm going to memorize the word. I'm going to stop what I'm doing, whatever it is. If I'm translating, if I'm looking up, if I'm studying, I'm going to stop, and this is going to be my mission, to memorize this word, eta. That way I don't have to come back again for a fourth time, right? We're trying to be efficient and effective in our language learning. So here we go. We stop. We memorize the word. We practice a little bit. Maybe we write it down 10 times. We make our flashcard. We review the flashcard, and then we master it, and then we move on. Hope that helps.